Hi, I'm Andrew from Creative Guitar Studio. Over the weekend, I had a question sent in off my website from Yakov out in Russia. He wrote in saying, I'm 15 years old, and I've been studying guitar for about a year now. I like rock and metal, but I'm not sure about a technique called double picking. Can you please demonstrate it and explain what it is on the guitar? Your videos on YouTube are great. Thank you for making free lessons. Well, thanks for writing in, Yakov. You know, if you like hard rock and metal, then you'll really enjoy working on double picking. You know, the concept of this technique is very straightforward. Essentially, it's a technique where you basically just play every note twice. And as well as being a cool way to make a riff sound heavier, double picking technique is an excellent overall alternate picking performance builder. So if you want to add a boost to your arpeggios or just give a little bit of diversity to pick lines, then this will be a relatively easy technique to add into your playing. Now, keep in mind that this technique relies heavily upon alternate picking, which of course is the alternate use of down and up strokes while playing single note lines. But by additionally including some palm muting to double picking technique, you'll create a killer punchy staccato effect that'll have you sounding like those classic metal riffs found in the likes of Iron Maiden or Motorhead or the Scorpions or that classic heavy metal style. So anyway, next let's zoom in on the guitar neck and I'll go over a few more details about double picking for you. As I made mention earlier, the technique of double picking is fairly straightforward. All you're doing is you're playing every note twice. And you can start practicing this with something quite simple, like perhaps a natural minor scale. Just go through the natural minor scale and play every tone two times. And you can start working it with a metronome and speeding it up a little faster. Of course, you want to also work with it with palm muting and without, and you could work with a dirty channel like I've got the overdrive on now. You could turn that off, of course, and work with a clean channel also. But I think it's really important, however, to work quite a bit with palm muting. I think the technique really shines with the palm muting approach. And if you're not too familiar with palm muting, basically what you're doing is you're taking about maybe, let's say, about a quarter of an inch or so of your palm, and you're just letting it rest right where the strings roll over the saddles of your bridge, and then you'll get that nice palm muting effect. It's kind of a real punchy, real cool effect. Very good for hard rock and heavy metal. So it really makes it shine. And one other thing I wanted to mention, though, with this technique is it doesn't have to exclusively be dedicated to alternate picking. Like, for example, if we took the double picking workout sheet that I put together here for the lesson plan and looked at that for a second, maybe with something like that, you could try doing all downstrokes. Now, it might be a little bit difficult for you in the beginning to play faster with all downstrokes, but trust me, it's well worth it to learn it because it does give you a little bit more heavy driving attack. You can start to notice it right away. Eh? So it gives you a little bit more drive, a little more punch to do all downstrokes. It can be a little bit more technically challenging to do that fast when you compare it to the alternate style picking because that's just so much more economical to do alternate. But just thought I'd mention that because that's also a very cool approach with this. But as you can see, it's a very straightforward technique, very easy to do. So the double picking technique can work with just about any scale or arpeggio line. Plus, with it combined in use with things like palm muting or cross picking, pedal tones or ascending and descending sequences and all kinds of other picking techniques. There's several great ideas that can come out of the application of this skill. Plus, when you pick each note twice, you automatically achieve a really cool driving, sort of flowing, swirling kind of effect that really fits great with playing metal. So anyway, thanks for watching. Keep jamming and practicing on this stuff. There's a tap chart for this lesson plan. You can grab the handout over at andrewwasson.com. Also, be sure to follow me on Twitter for other lesson material updates and stay tuned to my guitar blog YouTube channel where I answer subscriber questions and rant about all things music and guitar related and all kinds of other stuff. The links are all in the description box below. Take care, everybody, and I'll catch up with you next time. Bye for now.